Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be discussing about physical design of IoT. Here I'll explain you physical aspects of designing IoT system. So let us start this session with basics of physical design of IoT. See, when you design IoT system, it doesn't mean you will be designing device. Here there are so many things that you need to focus about, like what will be end devices, as well as with end devices, how IoT system is interacting, all those things that we need to take into the consideration. So here, physical design is more than creating products. Here we are not just talking about creation of products. Here, how product will be interacting with IoT system, that also the case which we need to take into the consideration. So physical design includes things, devices, and protocols. In things, you will be observing we are having smart devices, or you can have sensors, or you can have actuators. Along with things, there are some devices that we use it in IoT system, like you'll be using gateway, like you may be using storage devices. Those storage devices may be there at cloud, right? And for an interconnection of things, devices, we need to understand how protocols are there. So in physical design of IoT, we need to focus about things, devices, and how we can interact things and devices with the use of protocol. So here node devices will be performing remote sensing, actuating, and monitoring work. See, in node devices, you will be observing, you will be using sensors and actuators. Sensors are used to sense physical elements like temperature, moisture, like you may be sensing sound. It depends on application, right? So here sensing, that is the essential part. Once you sense the data, we need to monitor the work. Once you monitor the work, you will have to take the actions. So actions are taken with the use of actuators, right? So node devices will be performing remote sensing, actuation, and monitoring work. The protocols are used to establish communication in between node devices and server. So here you need to understand protocols as well. With the use of protocols only, we'll be providing communication in between things and devices, right? Here, we are discussing about forming overall intelligent system. See, when it comes to IoT system, at the time it is not only about end devices. Here you will be discussing about how overall system is there with given IoT application, right? In physical design, one understands the most effective method of storing and accessing objects. So here you need to understand how exactly storage is happening, how access of data is happening, how access of object is happening, all the picture that you will be observing to have a final application, right? Now I'll explain you things part of IoT system. So when it comes to things part, you should know things part is having in general three elements. It can have sensors, it can have actuators, or it can have smart devices. Sensors and actuators that we embed with embedded system. In embedded system, you can have microcontroller, microprocessor. Along with that, you will be interfacing sensors and actuators. There are some smart devices even in which you don't need to have separate embedded system, right? In a way, you can say sensors are used for sensing the physical elements and actuators are used to provide physical response to the application. Now, I need to go out to explain those points. See, things in IoT pertain to devices, those are used for actuation, monitoring, and remote sensing capabilities. And it is used for following functions. Those functions are like collection of data. Those data will be sensed as per physical data. Exchange of data as well, where things will be exchanging data with IoT cloud, as well as it will be performing some task with the use of actuator. And that task is being performed based on programs and algorithms. So here task is performed by actuator. So that is how things part is there with IoT system. Now I'll explain you generic block diagram of IoT device. So let me explain you that block by block. See, in first block, let us try to understand how connectivity is there. See, connectivity should be given to things with IoT server, and for that, one can have connectivity protocols based on USB, or you can have protocols based on Ethernet, right? So that is how connectivity is provided. When it comes to processor, in that usually you will be focusing on CPU. Generally, in embedded system, we will be using microprocessor and microcontroller that is used to optimize our application, by which one can decide operational speed of given application. Here, third block is there based on audio-video interface. See, audio-video inputs and outputs can be provided over here with the use of audio-video interface, where you can have HDMI and RAC for audio-video, as well as for audio, you can have 3.5 mm jack. Fourth block is there based on I/O interface. See, in I/O interface, usually you will be having sensors, actuators, and smart devices. And for interconnection or for communication, serial communication protocols are there, like UART, SPI, I2C, and CAN. Next block is there for storage interfaces, where one can have SD, MMC, and SDIO. Next block is there based on graphics. For excellent performance of picturization, graphics is required. And with graphics, we will be having GPU with given IoT application. And last block, that is there regarding memory interface. In memory interface, nowadays we are using DDR5. But in previous applications, we have been using DDR1, DDR2, and DDR3, which we use it for memory interface with given IoT application. Now, I'll explain you brief overview regarding IoT protocols. See, IoT protocols are providing path of communication in between devices and things. In IoT, we are having things. Those things are sensors, actuators, and smart devices. Things is interacting with IoT server, which is there on internet. So, for a communication, here we will be using internet. And that communication establishment is been defined by IoT protocols. So here, IoT protocol provides foundation of IoT system. It facilitates network connectivity and establishes communication between devices and applications. So here, for network connectivity and communication in between devices and application, we need to understand IoT protocols, right? IoT protocols allows devices to exchange data over the network. Network means on the internet, we are exchanging the data, right? Here, IoT protocol defines following essential aspects. First one is data exchange format. See, in which format we exchange the data, that has been defined by IoT protocol. Like IPv4 can be used, IPv6 can be used at network layer. At data link layer, you can have protocols based on Ethernet. You can have protocols based on token ring protocol, right? So based on protocol, data exchange formats will be there. Data encoding schemes are also defined at IoT protocol. Addressing schemes for devices is also defined at IoT protocols. And routing of packets from source to destination, that is also defined at IoT protocol. Routing means what will be the path for transfer of data, that is very essential when it comes to internet, right? So all these aspects are defined at the side of IoT protocols. Here, when it comes to data transmission, then one should know IoT protocols are providing data transmission with following functionalities. So here we need to understand functionalities. See, there are three functionalities. First one is sequence control. Sequence control explains you what will be the sequence of packets by which devices can understand whether data transmission is proper or not. Second functionality is flow control, by which data transfer rate is being justified over here. As if higher data transmission rate is required, then IoT protocol will justify it with the use of some functionalities. Based on the requirement, flow control will be maintained over here in between source and destination. And as if packet lost is happening, in that case, retransmission of packets are also provided over here. So based on the requirement, these functionalities are enabled at the side of IoT protocols. Now, I'll be discussing about IoT protocols, which we use it on internet. See, in general, there are 7 layers in OSI model. But for TCP/IP, usually we have 5 layers. First layer is physical layer, that we already use it in internet. Other than that, there are 4 layers which we also use it for IoT. Let me explain you all 4 layers step by step. So layer number 2, that is data link layer. Here in data link layer, there can be varieties of IoT protocols like Ethernet. We can have Wi-Fi, we can have WiMAX, we can have cellular protocols like 2G, 3G, 4G, 5G, LTE network, right? So that is how different protocols are there in data link layer. Here I'm just giving you basic overview. All these protocols that we will be studying it in future coming videos in this lecture series of Internet of Things. Here, next layer is network layer, in which usually we use IPv4 and IPv6 in 2020. Next layer, that is transport layer, in which we have TCP and UDP. Usually these two protocols are only used. Other than that also, there are many protocols which I have already covered in computer network lecture series. But in general, we are using TCP and UDP protocols. TCP is there for connection oriented services and UDP is there for connection less services. And last layer is application layer, in which there are many protocols like HTTP, CoAP, WebSocket, MQTT, XMPP, DDS, AMQP. All these protocols that we will be studying in future coming videos. Here I am just giving you brief overview. Let me explain you what is the meaning of all these layers. See, application layer will be giving raw data. So here there will be raw data. Now that raw data will be bisected into small segments with the use of transport layer. Those segments will be translated into packets with the use of network layer. For a formation of packets, we'll be using IPv4 and IPv6 in majority of cases. And those packets will be given to data link layer, where there will be formation of frames, and that frame formation structure is there based on protocols as per Ethernet, Wi-Fi, WiMAX and cellular technology. That is how data hierarchy will happen and exchange of data happens in between devices. That is how things are happening in internet as per physical design. I hope you have understood all those things. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.